Here in Adorama, we want your dreams of sound production to soar. So we're going to pair it right back to the basics. These Back to Basics shows will help you understand the very basics, the equipment, the terminology, the concepts, and hopefully give you the confidence and knowledge to either record your first song or even design your own soundscape. In this episode, I want to show you how to use a computer as a recorder. I'm suggesting a computer as it will allow you the most versatility and expandability as you progress and gain in confidence with your abilities. You can use a desktop or a laptop, either is a good option. There are a billion old computers out there, so ask your friends and family if they have an old one you could have. If your machine is a bit slow, then bring it down to the repair shop and get an SSD or solid state drive. Put it in to replace the old hard drive. The replacement will turn a slow machine into a machine that's quite quick and be much better for working with sound. When you get your machine home, I want you to look at the computer's settings window. On a Mac, it's called System Preferences, and look for the sound icon. Click on it. On a Windows PC, find the settings window, and under Devices, you'll find the sound icon. Click on it. In either systems, you'll see your options for sound output and sound input. This is where a lot of problems may occur when your computer does not recognize any sound equipment you may have attached to your computer. If so, your sound software will have a problem working for you properly. If you're having any problems with the sound equipment that's attached to the computer, the sound options in the settings window is the first place to check for any issues. Make sure that your equipment is listed and the list of sound devices out and the sound devices in. It may be listed in a drop-down menu. When I say sound equipment attached to your computer, I mean any equipment that allows you to put sound in or out of your computer. A device like this is called an audio interface. It could be an external interface or an internal sound card or even a USB microphone. The range of such equipment is mind-blowing. As an exercise, have a look at the Adorama online store at the Computer Audio for Video section. Familiarize yourself with the language that they're using and the descriptions, and see if you can recognize common properties in different pieces of equipment. We'll go through the terminology and go through the properties of lots of different equipment as we go along. As always, if you have any questions, put them in the comments below. A lot of computers come with a mic input and a speakers out, which allow you to put in a computer mic and plug in some speakers, of course. The connectors are usually a 3.5mm jack. You can pick up a computer mic for pennies. And starting out, computer speakers will be absolutely fine. The mic input on laptops and some desktops can be very limiting, as the mic inputs can be really noisy because the components are generating electrical noise that go down onto your recordings. When you're looking on the Adorama site, look for a basic digital audio interface. That'll get you going. You'll need one or two mic inputs, a headphone option, as well as outputs to a set of speakers. A USB interface is totally fine. One thing to look out for is free software that bundles with your interface. A lot of companies that offer free recording software, and some even give away light versions of the big professional DAWs, or digital audio workstations. Most professional sound work is done on one of the many types of DAW, such as ProTools and Nuendo. We'll go through what they are and what they do in a later episode. What I want you to do when you have finished watching this video, and of course, clicking the like button, is go down and install a free audio software package called Audacity. When you open it, Audacity will work off the computer's default settings for the microphone and speakers. On a laptop, that'll be the internal mic and speakers. Click the big red button on the top left-hand side and it'll go into record. Say a few words, then hit the spacebar. Welcome to your first recording. Hit the spacebar again and listen to what you just recorded. What you're looking at is called a waveform. This is a picture of the sound you recorded. The quiet bits are the small waves and the loud bits the big waves. The two flashing green bars up to your top right are your meters. They measure how much signal is coming onto your recording and are used in all aspects of production. They are really, really important. When you see the green bars going into red, that means there's too much signal going onto your recording. The audio that you're recording will sound distorted. There's a recording volume slide. Now pull that down to reduce the amount of signal. The red peaks on your meters go, and you'll be looking at all green bars on your meter. This is you reducing the level going to your recorder. So when you're recording anything and you're hearing the audio distort, then reduce the recording level to protect your recordings and have nice, clean audio. If you just recorded your voice on your laptop, the recording might sound distant and with a lot of room around you. That's the reverb of the room. And the reason that you sound distant is because the laptop mic is far away from your mouth. Do another recording whilst leaning into your laptop and listen to both recordings. And that's me talking out here. And when I see the small waveform, I see the small waveform. And then I go in to the second recording and you see much more increase in your meters and the waveform. The first take is the distant and roomy version, and the second is clearer with less room. And you're probably seeing more level on your meters and a bigger waveform on the display. The reason you're hearing and seeing such differences are because of the proximity of the mic. The proximity of the mic is all about the position of the mic in relation to what you're recording. The closer to the source, the clearer the recording, because you're getting a more direct signal being recorded. Mic proximity, again, is really important when recording, and also something we'll look at later. In the meantime, have a really good play with your new software. I need you to experiment for yourself with the program. Have a look around it and see what happens when you start clicking on different stuff. There's also a manual that'll walk you through aspects of the program. Next time, we'll look at finding the best audio interface for you and how it'll work on your computer. We'll also look at a few aspects of audio software that are common to both free and professional programs alike. I'm Keith Alexander and you've been watching Adorama TV. Don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV for more great videos and tell us what you think. If I can answer any of your sound questions, no matter how silly you may feel they are, put them in the comments below. I will answer them. You can like, comment, or share this video. And please come by the Adorama Learning Center for more great tips and tricks.